In this video, we'll find the equivalent resistance across the point A and B. So, to find the equivalent resistance, first of all, consider that the potential at the terminal A, that is at point A, is VA. So, at this point, the potential is VA, and the potential at the terminal B is VB. Now, we can see that potential at this point is VA, and this is shorted. So, at this point, potential must be VA. Similarly, at this point potential is VB and this is shorted like this. So at this point the potential would be also VB. Now we can say that the potential difference across the resistors R1 is VA minus VB. So V potential difference across R1 is mod of VB minus VA. Similarly, the potential difference across the resistors R2 is equal to VR2 equal to VV minus VA. Similar case for resistors R3. Across this, the potential difference is VA minus VV. So VR3 is equal to mod of VV minus VA. Now you can see that the potential across all the resistors R1, R2 and R3 have the same value. So we can say that these three resistors are in parallel connection. So the equivalent circuit of this would be like the three resistors are in parallel. So A terminal, that is, and R1, R2, R3 are in parallel connection. This is terminal B. This is R1, R2, R3. Now you can easily find the equivalent resistance of these three parallel connection resistors. So if we find the equivalent resistance of these three and replace this with a resistance R, then the relation of them is 1 by R, that is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Knowing the value of R1, R2 and R3, you can get the value of R, that is the equivalent resistance of this circuit. In this way, you can get the equivalent resistance of this circuit.